Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Witcher 3. I have no idea what the fuck we're doing. I have no idea. I've been around this island like 4 times. I have no idea. I'm going to do one more time with you guys, because if I discover it, you're never going to believe me. So let's go ahead and do this. I don't know, man. I don't know. So I've been up, I've been down, I've been around, I've been things that don't even rhyme. So I don't even know, man. So here, we're gonna go this way this time, I guess. Left-hand rule, right? Let's do left-hand rule. Let's do left-hand rule. So stick as much as you can to the left side here. And we could talk to random people, I guess, if they really want to talk, but I doubt they will. We go inside houses? Nope, it's locked. Okay. Just shove people out of the way, because fuck it. Fuck you all. I don't care. Fuck you all. Get out of my way. Oh, man. Stick to the left-hand side. We'll eventually get there. I just don't know where there is. I would assume... You know what it probably is? It's probably, like, inside, like, the temple, right? Good folk of Novigrad. That would make kind of a decent amount of sense. Can I go in here? I mean, I realize that's not left-hand rule, but I want to do it anyway. Let's just stick here. You never know. You never know. It could be hit. Could be something around here. Just a door I can go inside. Are these all locked? These are totally all locked. Is there a land where I might find more of your kind? So they're just set pieces. Is that guy practicing pickup lines? Is that what he was doing?
Not a headache again.
A maiden? Maiden doing her own laundry seems unlikely, but alright, sure, whatever. And that's pretty much a dead end, right? Yeah, let's not jump off any cliffs just yet. I mean, I'm almost there, don't get me wrong, but I'm not there yet. So let's just keep on the left here. Left side, left side, left side. There you go.
No loitering around here.
No loitering. Does it look like I'm fucking loitering, man? Does it look like I'm fucking loitering? Out of my way. Out of my way. All of you. Out of my way. You can see Nilfgaard's banners from the city walls. Yeah, on a clear day, you know what else I can see? Your ass, okay? Let me out. I don't care. There's a door that actually opened. Holy shit. Hello, butler? Do I know you? Do I know about you? I mean, I can loot the dupling and the apple, so yay. Dried fruit, smoking pipe, that door's locked. Why can I go in here? Can't go past the rug, that'd be silly talk. Okay, we done? We're done. Excuse me, I'm trying to adhere to left-hand rule here. You guys are all in my way. Alright. Left-hand rule all along the cave. I mean, this is beautiful, don't get me wrong. But after a while, it kind of wears on you, you know? Now, see that white dot? That white dot would indicate an entrance, I would guess. So, we gotta go up? I mean, according to this, we're facing it. Witcher Sense got zilch, though. Witcher Sense says there's something below us, but... Hell, man, I don't know. Is that what it... That's what it is, isn't it? That's the white dot? But we tried to get there, and we couldn't. What is this over here? There's a fucking chest. How did I miss the chest like 4 times? Oh, man. Okay, 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 okay. Left-hand rule, left-hand rule. We're just keeping left-hand rule. Just, you know, don't lose your sanity yet. We haven't, don't, because that's how they win. That's how they win, is they sap your sanity, and then you start giggling like a madman, and the nice men in the white coats come by, and they take you away. That's not where we want to go. We don't want to go away. We want to actually find our way to where we need to be, which I'm pretty sure is right off the fucking cliff. I think it's right off the fucking cliff. Because what else could it possibly be? Note that I don't actually see that symbol anymore. It's that white snowflake symbol. It's gone.
You must sweat like a swine in that jacket.
Jacket? You think this is his fucking jacket? This is armor, my lady. Okay, I got nothing. I got nothing. I got fucking nothing. I'm tempted to jump. Radovid's not a whit better than Anir. But it's not going to help me if I jump, right? I'll just die. Even if I hit the water, I'm pretty sure I die. It's this way. There's a freaking marker on the map.
See a medic.
Also, a red dot that I don't quite understand. Oh, that's directional. It's saying it's down. Well, no shit, Sherlock, it's down. Alright. Maybe we just need to be a little unconventional. You know? take it from the, was it Morrowind? Oblivion? Might have been Oblivion. Where, you know, when you level up, it gives you those aphorisms until, like, level 20 or so. Where it's like, you know, sometimes you just need to go a little crazy. And then everything comes together. Something like that. So I'm wondering, if I go inside this building, is this actually, like, can I go inside this building at all? This building seems to have no actual doors. No actual, like, real doors. Okay. I'm just wondering if maybe, like, one of these buildings leads to some passages underneath the, in, like, the basement or something. Well, that's what this is, right? This was, yeah, so the butler's moved. There's nothing in here we can do. Okay, well, I guess we can loot that. Sure, what the hell? Get an old goat hide. What the heck? But nothing else in terms of anything active. This is also nothing. And, you know, just check Witcher Sense every once in a while. All right, let's try taking the stairs up. Maybe we go up to go down. Maybe that's what we need to do. Or maybe there's... I don't see. Jumping doesn't seem like a likely scenario here. So we'll try to go up. I guess that's the main door. Can we go up this? Go inside, I mean? It is locked. All right. All right, let's think about this. What are the other options here? I can't zoom in any further. That's not entirely surprising. Maybe we go into, like, here? Excuse me. Why is there... What? Oh, I guess if you hold down, you can actually choose the kind of marker. So you say, like, there's death here! Or, hey, look, we should definitely go here. How do I change the markers, though? Oh, I can just make a whole bunch of markers. How? Did I never know this before? All right, sure. We'll just say the place is full of death, okay? I don't know if we can actually move these. Can we move these now? Oh, yeah. We just right-click on them, and then they disappear. Interesting. I had no idea you could do that. All right, so that's the white marker there. I mean, it would make a lot of sense if you got to it from, like, the chapel. Or from underneath, I guess. But I really didn't see... Yeah, so that's directional. That's telling me, hey, dummy, you need to go down a level. Well, no shit, Sherlock. I know that.
Oh my.
We just finished last episode by swimming all around the island. Don't know if you realize that. Okay. So we go inside the chapel, which is where? That's got to be it right there, right? The biggest tower in the place. Always, you know, you're always looking for a religious institution. Look for something phallic. 9 times out of 10. That's going to be it. That's what you want. Hold on. Let me actually check something. Okay, just got a text. Just making sure not anything super important. It's not. I'm going to keep running. Keep running, though. There
How
you go.
How do you make a living? We've known monsters.
Taken to a guard post.
Okay, so through the chapel here is my theory. Is my theory. Where do we start here? I mean, anywhere, right? Got a lot of people around. Praying, that usually indicates something's gone horribly wrong. Can I go in here? Oh, hey, what do you know? Can I go in here? Yes. Can I go down? Well, I'm going down. That say evidence? That just say evidence? I didn't... What? What? That just say evidence? I don't know if that... I don't know if that's what that said. I don't know what I picked up. Did that say evidence? All right, that's the painting. All right, anyway, let's keep going. Not quite where I wanted to be, but maybe. This seems to go out into the world. Yeah. Not actually where I want to be. Because this is the center area. I mean, it's fine, I'm sure, but not actually where I want to be right now. Let's see. Supposedly, it's over there, but we've already done this, right? We've already looked through that particular building, or looked around it anyway. Okay, so pass by you guys.
Where did you hear that?
That looks like a fake door. That's totally a fake door.
Yes, yes.
Now I'm just heading down, because I don't even know, man. All right, try going up this way. I realize we've abandoned left-hand rule. It's happened, okay? You have to get over it. You have to accept it. Left-hand rule wasn't for us. It's not for everybody. Collector Square, right, yeah, I know that's where we are. Okay, and we go back through this area. I like how all the doors are double hinged, so you never have to open a door towards you. All right, and up these stairs. How about through here? Is there anything? Well, there's loot. Hunting trousers, not exactly the best loot, but still loot. Some beer. Never go wrong with beer, right? Aside from, you know, all the ways you can possibly go wrong with beer. Horse Lister, we have totally read that book before. Alright, nothing else in this room, and not even a way out. Okay, well, that was just basically a loot room. Okay, so, not the building I'm looking for. What about the giant building right there, right? Biggest tower. What goes up may also go down. And also might have a cutscene. Not gonna charge through the middle of their little ceremony.
It is the supreme power. Over us, keep us in its care.
Okay. Eternal Fire Priest, go ahead and, you know, have your fun with the Temple of the Eternal, whatever's. I could also extinguish it. That'd be hilarious. No, I can't. Okay. That would be hilarious, though. If I could actually extinguish the Eternal Fire with my magic. That probably proved to them that I'm a heretic, though. I don't exactly want to give them ammunition for that. That is locked. Okay. I thought maybe, you know, the tallest place might go deepest. If nothing else, then for, you know, foundational architectural purposes. But maybe not.
Medallion's humming. Place of power.
Oh, right, that's place of power over there. Okay. We have an alternate path over here, which goes to nothing.
Got my eye on you.
What are you guarding, dude? What are you guys guarding? There's nothing here. There's nothing fucking here. Don't fall off the edge. Alright, I don't know if you guys know this, but it is stereotypical. I don't know how true it is, but it's stereotypical that when a person commits suicide, they take off their shoes before they jump. So someone jumped. We'll never find their body because they jumped into the lake here, but that would not be pretty. I mean, what are the chances are that you'll hit the water? Almost zero. I mean, look at that. That is not a sheer cliff. You would basically break your body on the rocks below. It would not be fun. But then again, I mean, if you go head first, maybe it's fast? I don't know, man. I don't advocate suicide. I think suicide's usually a dumb idea. There is a small percentage of times where I think suicide's okay, but only if, you know, you're facing imminent horrible death. And speaking of imminent horrible death, there's a guy who starved to death. Why the hell is there a skeleton here? What the heck? I don't understand. Also, we got more ammo, more of this, whatever this is. Heavy armor. You know what? I'm just curious what this looks like. It looks like it was put together by a court jester. That's what it looks like. What we were wearing was better. Where's what we were wearing before? Oh, right here. Duh. Replaced it. Okay. I mean, not pretty, but it's functional. It's
they
better than what...
never let your kind in, Novigrad proper. Duty calls.
Alright, so, yeah, Medallion's humming because there's a place of power right here. Didn't I already grab this? I already grabbed this, right? I mean, I could draw again? That would just replenish my, yeah, there we go, Igni sign increase that I just did last episode, okay. Alright, so I think we can pretty much confirm nothing up here, right? Unless I missed something. I could have missed something. I'll grant the possibility. I'm not the best person in the world in terms of finding anything, but we also didn't do a full left-hand rule, which I admit is definitely my own failing, but
and if some damage comes,
I'm also not entirely sure it's here because the all indications from the marker is that it's below. And why wouldn't you point me towards the entrance, you know? So I think it's below. So I think what we're gonna do is use the boat to go around again. And maybe there's a better way to get in. Maybe there is, in fact, some cellar or something we're missing. But I don't know. I don't know. Like I said, I've been all around this place a couple of times, so it's hard to tell. We could, of course, just fast travel the hell out of here. And that's definitely something I'm considering, to be sure. Let's see. That's where I want to go, right? I want to go down. The refugee here? Okay, definitely. Police state here. Alright, so I guess we just take the stairs. This is a weirdly designed place. I mean, it's kind of designed... kind of designed like, shoot, I'm forgetting the name of the city.
Did you see those poor wretches who fled Velen?
The name of the city in Lord of the Rings, that's basically built into a mountainside. I've totally forgotten the name of that city. We're gonna head all the way down. Maybe we'll just get out of my way. I'm sure we wouldn't have any problems whatsoever. I suppose I could also sell something to somebody, but... Well, this door looks like something I can go through. Nope, locked. Okay. I guess use Witcher sense to be able to find the ones you can actually go through. That we don't actually have to go up to them. Alright, well, lots of witch hunters. We're gonna take a boat. We're gonna go around. We're gonna find something. And...
Witches of conjured rain.
Okay, I guess we could also just dive into the water. That could also be a thing. You climb up here. Thank you. This is the boat that I slightly misaligned my my angle of attack here. I don't know. The boat looks like it's in good working order. It doesn't back up very well, though. Yeah, because the wind only moves in one direction, I guess. Okay, there we go. There we go. We got it. Now, if we go over there and we look at the marker, is it going to say up? My guess is yes. My guess is it is going to say up. I don't remember. Hello, Drowner. I see you. Lots of Drowners. I don't remember from last episode whether or not that's true or not. So I wasn't paying attention. I keep forgetting that's what the little red marks mean. Little red marks around the objective mean up or down. That totally makes sense. I don't know why you choose red. I guess white wouldn't show up necessarily as well. Why not keep the objective gold on your map? I mean, it does it on the map when I hit M, but for some reason it doesn't do it on the map when I use another color. I just thought that was a chest I could grab, but Witcher Sense says it's already looted. Alright, so... Not quite yet. Turn a little bit more here. Okay, it says up. It says it's up. So, did I just jump down the wrong way before? Is there a better way to jump up? Or down, rather? And there's no way I can work my way up, right? Okay, get out of... Okay, let me think about this. I don't really see a way to do this. I know we're being surrounded by drowners a little bit here, but that's okay. If I go towards this, does that work? Basically trying to get a better perspective. Okay, now come over here. I see, as soon as I leave the boat, the perspective on the map changes. But yeah, it's definitely indicating up is the way to go. Now I don't think I can actually climb this rock. I think that's a fool's gambit. But climbing down, we could do. The trick is how. It's like they're saying, you know what? You want this cat diagram? Prove to me you're worth it. Okay, man. I mean, I guess we could try. Kind of did that before. It's definitely buried in there. Could it be a ladder? That'd be silly, right? It would be kind of silly. Oh, it's great. I didn't know I could just sit on the side of the boat. That's actually fantastic. I didn't realize that was a thing. Alright, so... We can try to go, like, in a little bit here. But there's not much to go in for. And then, of course, we trap the boat. And then the boat sinks, and then we all die. That is a thing that could happen. Going in here. And there's no Okay, the boat's a little injured. And I can only go so far. Okay. And now you're letting me back up the boat. Well, I appreciate that. All right, we'll do like a 7-point turn here if we need to. Or just hit the rocks, that's good too. All right. Well, I guess that means we go back up and try to jump down. Doing it during a storm seems like a really bad idea, but there's no actual, like, negative effects in the storm. Would that be worth it? That'd be worth it to have, like, you know, have, like, the storm make it so your footing is a little slippier. Slippery-er is what I was trying to say there. For some reason, I couldn't. I need to say it's slow. Would that add, like, anything to that? Or make it so, I don't know, like, take it from a survival game and make it so your reaction time is a little sluggish? That would probably suck, actually. That'd be horrible. Yeah, like, gameplay-wise, it'd be interesting, like, on a mechanics level, but it would actually be horrible to play. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go up one more time. We're going to go up one more time, and then we're going to try to... Yep, do that, exactly. This boat is in horrible shape. I would like to leave it forever. I would like to leave the helm, though. There we go. Okay. So, yeah, we're going to go up one more time. Then we're going to go try to go down the rocks. And it may be an awful idea. And maybe that I need to look at the wiki, which would be unfortunate, but sometimes that happens. I'm not even sure I'm going up the right way. I'm kind of, like, just barely going along the edges here. I do love how it changes everyone's garments to be a little shiny, a little sopping wet. You know, back in the days of the Roman Empire, to use an umbrella was a sign of weakness. Women were okay with using an umbrella because they didn't want to get wet, you know? But for a man to use an umbrella, it was like, okay, what are you, like, pansy? Pansy little girl? And really, you would get that kind of treatment. So, I mean, umbrellas are centuries old, but the usage of them is, or at least the universal acceptance of them, is another thing entirely. I'm still going up, so I guess this still kind of works. It's going to take me to the wrong place, but that's okay. It'll get me nearby. Now, the trick is we probably don't want to be right above it, right? There's probably a trick to it. I don't want to go here either. Okay, get out of the Church of the Eternal Fire here. This is Electra Square. Not Electra Square. So I'm, like, hallucinating. This is not Electra Square. It said Electra Square there for a minute. Hey, here we go. Get out. Now, I probably don't want to go, like, right above. Okay, so save here, because we got some good equipment, right? And if we die, then we don't have to load too far. But how do we work our way down here? Think. How do we do this? Think. Alright, well. I mean, going as close as possible, not a bad idea. And from where we were before, right above it, last time we tried that last episode, it kind of worked. The trouble was we didn't actually see, you know, an exit. Or an entrance, or anything, really. Really, I wouldn't have been satisfied with, you know, just a single chest somewhere, but we didn't see that either. Okay, so it's behind this building. Theoretically. Yep, down below us. Yep, that is a thing. Yeah, maybe. And there's a wide open area right over there. Oh, it's gonna hurt. Oh, wow, that hurt. That killed us. It's okay, that's why we had a most recent save that was fairly recent. Could have been the slippery rocks that killed us? No, that was just my own dumb planning, I think. It's a puzzle. It's a puzzle. I'd like to figure it out, but I don't want to waste too much time on it. But I really want to figure it out. It would seem like it says explore the passages under Temple Isle. Explore the passages under Temple Isle. The thing is, are there any other indications of where these passages are? Not really. There could possibly be a quest that indicates to me where the passages are. I mean, look at this. This here, this ridge, seems to be indicative of something, right? So, okay, follow the path to, like, the west side of the aisle. That's a little bit further down. Maybe it'll be more on par. I don't know if that's actually a thing, but maybe.
I truly wonder what will happen if the gutter's clogged.
I have no idea. I mean, see, the giant tower there would kind of seem to be the indication, but... So, okay, if there are no...
When it rains, it falls.
No entrances to the passages from, like, the temple side, then maybe the equivalent of, like, a heretic? Okay, so we go over here. Just wondering if there's a way down this way. No, that would just straight up kill you. And probably not enough to the west, maybe? I don't see anything. I don't even see the snow marker. I'm calling it a snow marker, so I don't know what else to call it. But that marker right there, down at the bottom here of the screen. Isn't that an indication of a false wall? Maybe? Save for me, baby. If I go down this way, am I just dead? I'm not dead yet. Now I'm dead. Yep. Can't really direct my descent very well. It's not from there. Right, the ARD sign can put out fires. Right, forgot about that. So theoretically, I could put out the Eternal Flame. That'd be hilarious. And I'd probably get attacked by pretty much every devout citizen and priest and guard in the entire city. I don't know how much more time I should spend on this. Okay, it's directly below me. Directly. So last time I think we did this on this side. And we're like towards it. To this little ledge here. Oh. Over this way. Holy shit. We made it to the grass. We made it here before, but I think we're still doomed. It still says it's below us. Below us where? Alright, so we made this jump before. We make it a G again. Good. Okay, the map just changed. I didn't realize that before. How did the map change? It still says it's below us, but it's indicating there's something here. Below us. Alright, I'm gonna do something silly and save right here. This might be a bad place for a save. So, you know, I'm gonna do a full save so I can at least revert back to the quick save. Now, we do have a save that puts us on the beginning of the island, if that's what we need to do. Could it be, like, in this little crook right here? I mean, that would seem to indicate... it's not necessarily an entrance. There might be an entrance over there. Let's try and see if there's anything in Witcher Sense. Though, we got nothing. Alright, well, that looks like a whole lot of downward... We go, that's the way we're supposed to go, is this way. That's where the entrance is, theoretically. We go in the crook. No, that's doom. That's instant death, and I didn't even fall all the way down. All right. If you have no other choice, make sure no one's watching. That's good. Can you put a bucket over their head? No, because it's not Skyrim. Alright, so to the left didn't work. I don't know, man. I might have saved it in a bad spot. But yeah, see, the map changed, though. So they're assuming when you're at this elevation, you're inside. Yeah, they're assuming you're inside already. Which means there must be a way to go in that isn't here. Roll. Yes. Maybe yes. Yes. This is it. Holy shit, we did it. And there's a path. There's a fucking path. There's a path right here, in case you were wondering. It's not really a path, but in case you were wondering, there's a path. You go down these steps. Not really steps. But you know where I was afraid to jump? Yeah, right there. You jump. You freaking moron. You jump there. I went the hard way. That's what I just did. Oh, that's hilarious. That's okay. Oh, man, you gotta laugh, because if you don't laugh, I'm gonna cry. All right, of course we saved the game. Oh, man, that's hilarious.
Something here. Where's that artifact Kira gave me?
Yep, because there's a false wall here. All right, no problem. All right, that's just, I don't know what that is, but I guess it's breakable. Oh, hey, look, super dark. Do I still have a torch? That was a crossbow bolt that I just wasted. Though, there is a creature over there. Is that a golem? It's totally a golem, isn't it? All right, well, how about this? We'll put on cat potion. Somewhere in my inventory is a cat potion. It doesn't last for very long, but it is at least some kind of light. That is whale, night wraith, griffin, werewolf, wyvern, wraith, foglet, grave hag, necker, blizzard, petri, pops, tawny, white honey, marbor, cat. There we go. That's a little better. Black and white, but still better. Hello, random golem man. Would you like to lend a hand, random mullen golem man? Okay. I know you're going to attack me anyway, so I might as well attack you first. Alright, you haven't actually gotten me yet. I'm getting better at attacking this guy. One hit. And then walk away. You're just bad at your job, man. My Quinn's not even up yet. Oh man, look at that. That's beautiful. You can't affect shit. I do like the highlight on it. Oh, a little too close, but that's okay. Go ahead and put Quinn back on. You can't do shit. Don't even worry about it. Oh, that affected me, but only got my Quinn. Only got my Quinn. You want to rush me? Come on, man. You want to rush me down. I know you do. Yeah, there you go. Knew you were going to do it. Knew you were going to do it. But now you're dead. Nice. That's how a Witcher takes shit down. Take all your shit. And now what? I totally forget which direction we came from. Got to be that way, right? I think we came from that direction. Shit, man. This is huge. Alright, okay, cat potion's gone, but that's okay. We totally used it for what we wanted to use it for. Okay, I do have my torch equipped, just not on the correct menu. There we go. Torch. Ta-da! Okay, pick up all the shit. Even if it's just sewing mushrooms. And see what else we got here. So, aside from sewing mushrooms, oh, hey, we can light up. That'd be good. Let's go ahead and light this stuff up. Go ahead and light this stuff up, though. There we go. We got it. Don't know what that was all about. Okay, another one. Okay, sure. Light it up. Yeah, sure. Gather the puffball, but that's not what I wanted to do. There you go. And this is definitely the direction we came from, I think. Yeah, there we go. Light all these torches, and that was the last torch. Okay. Somehow I missed these on the way in. All right. Yep, go ahead and light this one up too. Thank you. And we'll just explore all over the place. So is this elven? This looks elven. That I cannot light up. Oh, there we go. Light you up. This looks like we can just ard this, right? Yeah, there we go. Did we wake up any bad guys? I mean, I can't imagine they've lived this long in here, but what do I know? I mean, it's possible, right? They're magical creatures. It's so hard to tell. I heard some kind of noise there. Okay, well, there's water. Oh, could we have swum in here, too? Did I just take the hardest possible route? Oh, man. Possibly. Possibly. The drowner's in here. There's a box. No drowners, though. Alright. Dive. Dive. Unless the drowners just want to spawn in. But it should be right here. Okay. Nothing great, but still, you know, loot. This is not lead outside like I thought it did. Also goes away from where the cat school diagram is, but this is a really cool cave. I like this cave. I like the hanging fungus. Really cool. Nice effect. Anything else in here? Oh, yes there is. Look at that. Some linen. Oh, well, okay. Crap loot, but still. Invoice for a golem. Really, another guy? Goods purchased. Guardian golem, clay, porcelain. In the event of damage to ceramic, please report immediately nearest branch of Judo alone. Apprentices. Golem can only be serviced by qualified company personnel. All right, then. Anything else here? Yep, right there. Some more puff balls. Oh, poison. Right. One more plant. Oh, hello. Hello. Oh, level 7 wraith? I was scared there for a minute. Don't give it, man. Two hits. Probably from the guy who died there, my guess would be. Can't imagine any other candidates for that. Yeah, walking right through the poison. Probably not the brightest thing I've ever done. Right, there should be... Am I seriously poisoned right now? That was weird. I was being poisoned there for a second. Was it just because standing on those? I don't understand. Grab the sewing mushrooms. Is there another? Okay, maybe not. Alright, go ahead and swim to the other side here. Alright, so not much there, but you know, a little bit of things to sell. Alright, so let's actually look for the cat school witcher gear. I guess we haven't fully explored the ruins, otherwise that would be checked off. Right, torch. There we go. Light. Thank you. That'll also help us keep track of where we are in terms of what we've actually explored. Oh, mushrooms. Thank you. I'll ignite that. So it's got to be up those steps, right? I can't imagine it being anything else. I mean, it could be something else, but I don't know what. Yeah, there we go. I was going to say, I could have sworn we'd be able to do a lot like that. Just like so. All right, maybe we light all four of these and something magical comes out and tries to eat our face. That does seem to be the usual MO for these type of things. Let's go ahead and jump there. Probably don't want to stand on top of it when we do that. There we go. There you go. And then one more time. That. Well, all four of them are lit. I mean, it looks cool, but not really helpful at all, first of all. We haven't actually been up that direction. I just want to make sure there's nothing else to light over here. What is this? Just a random torch. Okay. And that's it. So let's go this way first. And see what's over here. Let's see what we got. Stairs, but no other things to light up. Unless that lights up. Yep, there we go. That lights up. So lots of things to light in case you don't feel like using your own torch, I guess. Oh, and hello. Random door. Don't suppose that'll be locked. Looks like they might be poisonous, but so hard to tell. Key required. Alright, but it is what I want to do, though. Alright, so my guess is go around the other way, right? Unless we need to find a key in another location far, far away. But at least we know how to get down here, so that's at least something. Okay, so I have not been here yet because these are not lit. Let's turn on a timer, which would be hilarious. That would make me lose my way pretty fast. Not quite as hilarious as not being able to find my way in after four circuitous routes. Guess we climb up this way. Alright, it got super dark, but that's okay. But your sense got nothing, huh? Alright, light this up. What else we got? A whole lot of nothing. Music changed, but I don't know if that means anything. Can I light this? I'd like to light this up, please. There we go. That's what I wanted. Just light things as we go here. Oh, okay. Some runes here in Elvish. Look to the depths to be lifted up. No idea what that means. Look to the depths to be lifted up. Alright, well, there's a nice priest there, I guess. And note. Research notes. As per the instruction of our supervisor, Erinus Barstarengard, we have conducted a series of studies on the genotype of the creatures commonly known as drowners. Sadly, administering a poison made of fugu fish introduced a coma in all the specimens in the study. After 24 hours, the vital function of all above specimens ceased, preventing us from continuing with the study. Why the hell is that here? Okay. Oh, maybe they all need to look over here. Yeah, they might all need to look at the in the middle here. That'd be my guess. There's a torch here, but I can't seem to light it. I can probably light this one though, right? Right. Right. Nope. Okay, never mind. Fuck you too. Okay, do this. Spin this around. I kind of almost expected these guys to attack, but it's not that sort of puzzle, I don't think. So yeah, I think they're all supposed to look... Well, how is that in the depths? I don't know, does it seem like it's gonna crumble or anything? Not really, but... I don't know, I don't really have another good option. Oh, hello. Okay, level 7 Wraith, no big deal. Actually, 3 hits that time. You know, walk all the way over and hit the... Okay, sure, do it. Not even, like, touching the controls at all. Go ahead and do that. I'll just leave my sword out. Oh, okay, he's totally facing the wrong way. So maybe that's what it was. It was a punishment for doing it wrong. And so the Wraith comes out and tries to eat your face because, you know, you screwed up. Now he's not moving in the right direction. Come on, man. Face the center. There we go. Okay. Now you need to face center, too. I don't know. It'd be hilarious if this isn't actually it. We need to face him in another direction. Let's see, you're facing off to the side, so one turn should do it, theoretically. The light turning off and on and off and on again. I do apologize for that, but there's no real better way to do that. There we go. And now I guess you face center-wise. What would make this really more frustrating is if when you moved one, another one moved two, so you'd have to puzzle out, but I think instead it's just going to let us move them all to the look towards the center. And did that actually work? Well, it created a lot of things for us to... Yep. You're examining, but you didn't actually like tell me what you were looking at. Do we actually have to go down? Well, it did say we had to go down to go up, right? Or go into the depths to be lifted, I suppose. Oh yeah, there's a drowners, all right. There's no reason for us to go down. We can probably just shoot them from here. Not actually what I meant to do there. What I meant to do was go to the crossbow and like lock onto one of these guys and then shoot one. That did not work. I suppose I have to actually aim. It's also not work. My crossbow bolts are unfortunately being wasted here. I don't know if I'm actually... I'm not hitting anybody, am I? I can't... I'm gonna have to go in. Unfortunately, can I jump to one of the other sides? With a shot. Yeah, there we go. Well, what do you know? There's treasure down there. Who would have guessed it? Most likely the key. Alright. Nope, I'm gonna have to go down. Wasted like 8 crossbow bolts here. Alright guys, come get me. I can't actually dive, alright? One down. Yep, I know. Two down. I know. There we go, 3 down. Okay, go up and breathe. Thank you. Probably heal. What do you think? Water? It'd be kind of ironic to drink some water while you're in the water. Sure, why not? And then go and dive again. And there's a chest down here, right? There's something. I saw something glowing. What the hell is it? Oh. Is it that thing over there? Yes. Yes, it is. I will totally take your lab key. Alright, so that should take us to where we want to go. And I'm only going this way because it seems right, but I don't actually know. Yeah, up. Up, I say. There you go. And then over this way. Alright, looks like the drowners don't actually have any loot for us, but, you know, come to expect that sort of thing. Alright, let's go back and use the key. Suppose I can use the torch and get the torch out again. There we go. Alright, jump down. I was practically expecting a tactical roll there. He disappointed me. Come on, Geralt. Losing your touch. Alright, so the... Right, it was up here. In the nice fancy area. My guess is there's going to be another monster for us to defeat. Maybe not. Okay, well, lights on, please. There is something in a meditative pose, but it could be a corpse. I mean, who knows how long these wizards have been here, you know? It's possible this guy's long dead.
No good.
Or not.
No evil. Only pain. No good. No evil.
Yeah, he's totally mad. Alright, I'm gonna switch to my steel sword. Oh yeah, there we go. Steel sword worked. Is he burned? So he's not,
This is not the end.
Oh wow. Good use there, good use. Go ahead and set you on fire there. Alright, so don't attack him while he has that up. And roll away. Come on, man. Don't do it. Don't do it. Told you not to do it. Okay. Well, that actually made it so he's not on fire anymore. Good use. Oh, good parry. Good parry. That unfortunately didn't save your life. So, okay, I don't even know who the hell this guy is. Who the hell is this guy? So, yeah, I guess we can extinguish one of those. Moonblade. Well, there's the diagrams I was after. And a laboratory notebook. What do you got? Likely a teleport deposit is directly in my laboratory. It's good to be home. I've grown sick to the gills of that leaky tub. Hope that storm I summoned smash it in those craggy rocks off the grassy knoll shore. Experiments with my student conducted on drowners in my absence and not yield the expected results. As usual, I must do everything myself. I'll administer a brew of medicinal opium to the subject. This milk of the poppy will keep the Witcher in a state of half-consciousness and thus incapable of any resistance. Commencing studies. Note, I must hold off my planned experiments while I clear up the demolished portion of my laboratory. I have set the bones in the forearm of one of my assistants. I will now administer a quadruple dose of milk of the poppy to the Witcher. Quadruple dose? I'm gonna fucking die, man. Witchers are strong, but still. Day 4. Subject shows incredible resistance to physical torture. Well, yeah, you're giving him heroin. Only broke after the second day of intense labor. Moderately satisfactory results from the interrogation, garnering information about the Witcher training and the Cat School Witchers in general. As expected, the Cat School Witchers are for the most part of elven stock. School must have some tie to the Elder Races, and perhaps its founder was a member of the Adansei. Subject unfit for further study, I've discontinued his doses of poppy. Day 7. Administered extract of cowbane and hemlock. In typical representative of the human and Adansei species, such a mixture provokes paralysis of the peripheral nervous system, and eventually of the nerve endings as well. This results in muscular, skeletal, and pulmonary and cardiac paralysis, and ultimately death through suffocation. Witcher is not, however, a typical representative of any species. Though the poison did seem to cause some mild irritation in his nervous system, his mutated body quickly managed to neutralize the harmful alkaloids. In a matter of hours, all symptoms of the poison I administered have vanished. Witchers are harder to kill than you think, especially by poisoning. Day 15. Sting of the sea wasp toxin did not provide the expected results. In order to strengthen the toxin's effect, I poured ethyl alcohol into his wounds. His nervous system seems to be immune. Day 26. Subject has been tortured, poisoned, burnt, frozen, starved, and dehydrated, and despite it all, his body continues to function. He eats and drinks by himself, moves about his cell on his own, and is able to articulate simple words. Please, drink, don't hurt, stop. Conclusion. As I suspected, the Witcher's superb and energumen, a demon trapped in such an excellently prepared body, will become death incarnate, vengeful wrath made flesh, and placed at my command. No one has succeeded in creating a being of such power since the time of Malispin and Alzor. This is a great day for science. Time to begin the incantations. So I wonder if that was, in fact, what we just fought? You seem kind of weak for that. My guess instead is that it was the mad scientist who was running the experiments. Well, lots of alcohol. That's actually great, because that helps us... Yeah, we already read that. That actually helps us replenish our stuff here. Superior Swallow. That's actually fantastic. I've been looking all over for that. That's great. Anything else we can loot? Monumenta Forum. Okay. I'm sure this is very interesting, but I don't really care right now. Anything else I can loot here? Yeah, that's right here. Water and lager. Not exactly prime things there. Anything else? Witcher Sense says no. Oh, ha! Yeah, all this stuff over here. I mean, maybe not as good. I think we already read Gnomish Plankings. Yep, and another version of Gnomish Plankings. I don't know if it matters to read them all or not, but I'm going to do it. Portrayal of the Elder Races, which is no doubt some really good lore. Oh, probably didn't want to extinguish that. Go ahead. And nothing else in the area? Oh, no, there we go. There we go. Blood Moss Crow's Eye. I mean, not great or anything, but not too bad. And Everloose. Looks like some really good wine. All right, there's no shortcut out of this dungeon, is there? That would probably be too much to hope for. All right, well, we can get out the other way, I suppose. The normal way. Which is which way again? That's a good question. I don't remember. Is it actually the farthest entrance or the farthest side? I think so. Yeah, because it wasn't the hugely lit up cave. It was this way. All right. Well, that was a lot easier to get into than I thought. And the creatures were super easy to defeat. I'm going to leave all the torches burning because that's what I do. It is now 9:18 p.m. I don't need a torch anymore, really. So I'm going to put that away. I suppose meditation would not be a bad idea. And then we can just get the hell out of Dodge. So, Explore the ruins of Drum Castle, search the wreck of the Flying Stag. So we haven't actually... Oh, because that's the one he wrecked. That's the one he wrecked. Okay, that makes sense. That totally makes sense. This is why we read some of the lore, because sometimes it's important to understand the context of the quest we're going on. All right, so where is it? It's like all the fucking way over here. Okay, and here's some question marks we were going to do anyway. So Drum Castle. We can actually go straight to Drum Castle, where we are, if we go to the Electric Square. Let's do that. It's this way. And then up and up and up again. Maybe to the side more than up? Yeah, just a little bit. It's windy. I'll be glad to leave this place forever. Most likely we're going to be coming back, but not necessarily anytime soon. Alright, so Drum Castle. There we go. That's where we want to go. And we should probably meditate so that it's daytime. Oh, is that a... That's a bandit. Hello, bandit. Really? Really? How about you just get off your horse? There we go. He got off his horse. Witch fucker? I mean, technically, I guess that's true. But how do you know about Yennefer and Triss? You've been following me. There we go. He's off his horse. And he's dead. Well, that was cake. Take your stuff. Right, speaking of stuff, we should probably sell, right? Is there any place to sell around here? Might just SOL. I mean, I can only carry 10 more pounds, man. There is a merchant up there, but I don't know how much he can buy. It's pretty much the only merchant in range, though. Alright, well, it's near the end of the episode. How about this? I'll go over, sell what I can, and then come back. And as far as you guys know, it's just like I magically dump my inventory somewhere. Chances are you won't be able to afford much, but it'll at least be something. So, thank you guys for watching. This has been Witcher 3. I'm PC Universe, you're PC Universe 2, and I'll see you guys next time.